Hello, once again, we have another good lesson for you. I'm John Shannon. Today's lesson, the Churches of Christ, God's Peculiar People. Our text is taken from 1 Peter chapter 2, 9 through 11. Please stay tuned. You can be turning to 1 Peter chapter 5, 2, in verse number 5, first. We're grateful to see the number that's back tonight. Amen. I hope that I can see today. Before I die, I have members at James Road who profess to be Christians. Amen. Would come to all of the services.
Amen. Amen.
That may be wishful thinking. We have what we call many Sunday morning Christians.
Amen.
I call them Sunday morning Christians. They'll come on Sunday morning, not Sunday night. Huh? Hope that we can get to the point in our service to God where that's not the case.
Mm-hmm.
But nevertheless, we must go on. Tonight, we have a lesson, thanks to Brother Thaddeus Johnson for reading that text.
Amen.
Did a marvelous job.
Amen.
There, appreciate the prayer. Brother Bullock.
Amen.
And Brother Brown is just getting better and better. We appreciate him.
Amen.
We want to talk tonight, the Churches of Christ, God's peculiar people.
Yes, sir.
Are you listening?
Amen.
Now, maybe some of you have heard this lesson over and over. But when you teach and baptize people, they don't know this.
Right.
And you'll be surprised of the members of the Churches of Christ who attends regularly. They don't ever hear this.
Right.
Never hear. And I think preachers make the mistake because they know certain things that the members know it. No, that's not true. Now I'm learning that you have to repeat stuff over and over. I was looking at the number of charts that I have. I have 530 charts. That's a lot of charts. Sometimes you forget them. And they're all good because it's from the Bible. Now we start here. Peter says, but ye are a chosen generation.
Right.
Let me stop a minute. Let's go to verse 5. Thank you, Joe. Peter says, ye also, as lively stones, are built up, watch it, a spiritual house.
Mm-hmm.
Now, first of all, the Church of Christ is a spiritual house. It is not a physical building.
Amen.
Now, if it were a physical building, everybody couldn't get in it. So it's a spiritual house. Isaiah talked about that. All right. All nations shall afford it. Build up a spiritual house, a holy priesthood, to offer up spiritual sacrifices. Well, where are the spiritual sacrifices made? They're made in the spiritual house. But what is the spiritual house? It's the church. Well, if you are not in the house, the spiritual house, it is impossible for you to worship God.
Amen.
Outside of the church.
Amen.
Got it?
Yeah.
All right, now watch this here. To offer up spiritual sacrifice acceptable to God. How? By Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now watch this here. You won't understand, watch it, holy priesthood, watch it, if you don't know that it's through Jesus Christ who is our high priest.
Right.
See, Christ is the high priest and you worship God through the high priest. And amen. Got it?
Yeah.
That's pretty good, isn't it? Now we'll go to verse 9. Pretty good? And look at it. He said, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praise of him who have called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Now watch this. Which in time past were not a people, but are now the people of God, which has not, which had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy.
Right.
Then he says in verse 11, I like this verse 11. It says, watch it. Dearly beloved, please listen, Christians. I beseech you, I beg you, as strangers and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lust, which wars against the soul.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Now, he's not writing to the world.
Right.
He's writing to Christians.
Right. Right.
Now, we want to talk about the churches of Christ, God's peculiar people. Now, watch this now. In Romans 16:16, it says, salute ye one another with a holy kiss. The churches of Christ salute you.
Uh-huh.
Got that? All right. We are a people that are, watch it, chosen, consecrated, claimed, communicated, called. We're Christians, and we're covered. That's the text. Watch this now. But ye also are a chosen generation. Watch this, brethren. In Ephesians 1, are you following me? Ephesians 1 and verse number 6 there. Now, verse number 4. I'm going to show you something. That's pretty good. Ephesians chapter 1 and verse number 4. I really want you to look at this because sometimes people don't understand, you know, about chosen. Ephesians 1 and verse number 4, it says, according as he has chosen us in him. Look at the text. It did not say we are chosen to be in him. We are chosen in him. So when you obey the gospel, you are part of the chosen one. It's not talking about God just reach out and get certain people and choose them to be Christian. No, you are chosen in him. If you're not in him, you're not of the chosen one. Now Peter says here, but ye are a chosen generation. Well, who is he talking to? He's talking to Christians. Because he says, seeing you have purified your soul in obeying the truth through the spirit of the unfeigned love of the brethren, see that you love one another with a pure heart, verbally, being born again, not of corrupt seeds. That's 1 Peter. So you're a Christian. So you're a chosen generation. Pretty good? So we're chosen. Amen. Aren't you proud to be part of the chosen?
Amen.
Now watch this here. Consecrated, a royal priesthood and holy nation. Well, what does that mean? You can't name the name of Christ. You don't have no many names. You can't. Listen here. You're consecrated. You're set aside.
Right.
Wait a minute. You just can't do anything you want to do.
Amen.
A lot of members of the body of Christ make that mistake. And they think that, well, I'm grown, I do what you know. Your body don't even belong to you.
Amen.
We've been bought with a price. Are you listening?
Amen.
I got to rush on here now. We've been claimed a peculiar people.
Yes, sir. Yes.
What makes us peculiar? The doctrine of Christ.
Amen.
What else? Christ.
Yes, sir.
We're in Christ. Oh, you got it? Peculiar people. Well, communicating people that ye should show forth for the praise of him. Wait a minute. Are you listening?
Mm-hmm.
We are somebody.
Amen,
community. The world needs to know who we are.
Right.
We need to know who we are.
Yeah.
You know, you take salt and sugar and put it in one here and one there. Off a distance, they look the same.
Uh-huh.
They look the same. You got it? But the proof is in the pudding. When you taste it, you'll know it's different.
Amen.
Let me tell you something, good people.
Yes,
we need to stop trying to be like the world.
Yes, right.
We have no business trying to be like denominational people.
Right.
We are not part of them. We can't keep up with the denominational people in the physical realm. You can't do that.
Right.
And you're wasting your trying to. We just need to be who we are.
Right.
Amen. Amen. That pretty good? Now, call. Who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. What do you mean? Listen, we're different from the world. We need to know who we are. Do you know who you are? Do you know that you're a member of the body of Christ and God expect you, watch it, to have this high calling?
Yes, sir.
High calling.
Right.
Amen, somebody. Who hath called you out of darkness into the marvelous light. We don't walk in darkness. Ephesians chapter 5, verse number 8. We were sometimes children of dark, but now we're the light. The light. Is it all right? Now, look here. We're Christian, which in time past were not a people. Before you obeyed the gospel, you were not a people of God. But he said, but are now the people of God. So who are we? We're Christian. We're Christians. Amen. That pretty good?
Good?
Not only that, but we're covered. Which had not obtained mercy. No mercy outside of Christ. But now have obtained mercy. Look at it. So far we talked about we've been chosen in him. Amen. We're consecrated. We're set apart. We're claimed by God. We're communicating. Watch it, to God. Watch it. We're called. Amen. We're Christians. And we're covered. Now, up here we have, watch it, in Christ. If you looked at Ephesians, not Ephesians, in Revelation, we're not going to turn there. Revelation chapter 1, 11, and 20, it talks about the seven churches of Asia. Some individuals go read that and say, well, you talk about it just one church. Well, the Bible talks about seven churches.
Right.
Well, amen, somebody. Amen. Looked like Joe wanted to get that so bad. He learned how to use that machine there real good, and we can put it up there. Revelation 1:10, that pretty good?
Good.
Hey, is that all right? Revelation 1:10, he's doing good there. We're going to look at, amen, are you with me? Revelation 1 and verse 10, look what it says. Amen. I was in the spirit on the Lord's day and heard behind me a great voice as of a trumpet. Read it. Come up there, Joe. Then it says, watch it. Watch verse 11. We talk about these seven churches saying, listen, Jesus said, I am the Alpha and Omega. Well, what do you mean Alpha and Omega? Alpha is the first letter in the Greek language. Omega is the last. You got it? Are you with me now? Are you with me? Please listen to me now. I got to do a little teaching that's going on. Don't have long. You see, Alpha, amen, and Omega. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Look here. Just in case, well, what do you mean Alpha and Omega? Then he says, watch it, the first and the last. Well, what are you talking about? First and last. Look at here. See, A to Z. Are you following me? What do you do from A to Z? You make words. Jesus said, I'm Alpha and Omega. What does that mean? He's the Word. He's the Word, right? To let you know what then he says, the first and the last. Alpha is the first word in the Greek language and alphabet, and Omega is the last. Got it? So Christ is the first and the last. You don't need nothing else. That pretty good? And what thou seest, he told John, write in a book. A book. Look at it, Trey. In a book. In a what? In a book. B-O-O-K. Not books, book. Watch it. And send it, what it? The book, unto the seven churches which are in Asia. Watch it. Unto Ephesus, unto Smyrna, unto Pergamum, unto Thyatira, unto Sardis, and unto Philadelphia, and unto Laodicea. Right? Look at this. Oh, boy. And it's good. Now drop down to verse 20. Let me show you something. See, if you see it, watch this. See, look at verse 20. The mystery of the seven stars which thou sawest in thy right hand are the seven golden candlesticks. And the seven stars are the seven angels and the seven churches, watch it, and the seven golden candlesticks which thou sawest are the seven churches. And watch this. Each one of those churches were made out of gold.
Yes, sir.
You would have won the argument if one of them were made out of brass, or zinc, or iron, or copper. Right. But they were all made out of the same thing, gold.
Yes,
so that make them the same.
Amen.
Are you listening to me?
Amen.
Somebody say amen. Are the same. All these churches right here, it was just churches of Christ in different locations, but were they all same church? Let me stop here a moment. If you ask some little kid, how many McDonald's there, they'll tell you it's one. Well, how many stores? I don't know. But there's only one McDonald's, right? There's only one church, amen, but there are many locations. Somebody say amen. Is that all right? That's good, isn't it? That's pretty good, isn't it? That pretty good? Boy, I like that. Wait a minute. Let me pull this around right quick here, and we'll do this here. That's pretty good, isn't it? Amen. We're good here. Is that pretty good? Look what we have. Ephesians 4:4, there's one body. Look at it. See that? Write it. Ephesians 1:22 and 23 has put all things on his feet and gave him to be head over all things to the church, which is his body. Ephesians 2, verse 16, watch it, that he might reconcile both unto God in one body.
Right.
What is the one body? The church.
Amen.
Ephesians 3, 6, it says that the Gentiles should be fellow heirs, Mike, and of the same body, a same church.
Yes.
Got it? Watch it. Ephesians 5, 25, 23, husband, love your wife, even as Christ also loved the church. Got it? That's not what I want. Ephesians 5:23. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the savior of the body. What's he going to save? The body. How many? One. Well, he saved me, but I'm not in the body. Well, no, you're not saved. Because if you're not in the body, you're not saved.
Amen.
Because what is he going to save in the body? Somebody says, no, he saved you when you obey the gospel, and when you obey the gospel, you're in the one body.
Right?
1 Corinthians 12. Verse number 27. Pretty good? 1 Corinthians 12, verse number 13. Let's look at it. Let's look at 1 Corinthians 12:12. That all right? 1 Corinthians 12:12. I'm trying to do this in the time that allotted me here. Amen. He got me on a tight schedule here, so I don't have no time to waste. Amen. 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and verse number 13, I believe, here. 12:12. All right, look here. For as the body is one and has many members, bring it in. One body, many members, and all the members have not the same, and all the members of that one body, being many, are one body, so also is Christ. Look at verse 27. That's pretty good, in all 20. Verse 20, that's good, isn't it? All right, look what it, but now are they many members, yet but one body. Got it? Look at verse 27, watch what it says. Look at verse 27, that's what it said? Look at it. Now ye are the
body.
What?
Body.
The body of Christ and members in particular.
Yes,
that's good teaching. Brethren, this is Brother Philip. This is the kind of preaching that I was brought up on 35 years ago.
Amen.
Everywhere you went, this is what you heard.
Amen.
In a gospel meeting. That's why we were so strong back then.
Amen.
And if we don't give this same stuff to folk today, they won't be strong in the faith.
Amen.
That pretty good? Well, let's go a little further here now. We dealt with that now. Churches of Christ are peculiar to other churches or denominations in that they are, watch this here, man. Watch this. Look at this. That pretty good?
Amen.
Man. Watch this here. They are purchased. Acts 20 and verse 28, take heed therefore to yourselves and to all the flock over which the Holy Ghost have made you overseers to feed the church of God, which he purchased with his own blood. So the church, watch it, was purchased with the blood of Christ. Somebody said, well, the church is not important. If the church is not important, the blood is not important. It took the blood to purchase the church. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Amen. Is that all right? You have the purchase and your purchase price. You got it? Amen. You got it? All right. We are pitched by Christ. Jesus is the only man that says, upon this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Got it? Watch it. Hebrews 8 and verse 2, it says, a minister of the sanctuary and of the true tabernacle, which the Lord shall pitch and not man. Amen, somebody. Amen. Watch it. Watch it. Churches of Christ are peculiar, different from other churches in that we are purchased. Watch it. Speak only the precepts of Christ. 1 Peter 4:12, if any man speak, let him speak as an oracle of God. Paul told Timothy, and that from a child thou hast known the holy scriptures, which are able to make you wise unto salvation through faith, which is in Christ Jesus. Then he says, all scriptures given by inspiration of God. All of it, a problem for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect, truly furnished unto every good work. You got it? We, any man speak, let him speak as the heart of God. Amen. Right? 2 John 9, whosoever transgresseth and abideth not in the doctrine of Christ hath not God. There it is. Pretty good?
Amen.
Amen. We're going to go on. We're going to leave some of that here. We don't bind only what God bind. In Acts 15, 1, there was a controversy that came up by the Jews that told the Gentiles, said that the Gentiles had to be circumcised and keep the law of Moses.
Right.
Well, we want to find out if it's right. In Acts 15 and verse number 28, that's pretty good. Watch it. Luke wrote this, for it seemeth good unto the Holy Ghost. And unto us. What is it? It seemed good unto the Holy Ghost. Why? Because the Holy Ghost is guiding them in the truth.
Right.
The us are the people to lay upon you no greater burden than these necessary things. The what?
Necessary.
The necessary things. Right? Is it any more there? I think I'm on verse 24. Let's look at verse 29, and I don't think that's it. I think it's verse 24. Look at verse 24 there, Brother Joe. That's pretty good, Acts 15, 24.
Yes,
but see, he said the necessary thing.
Mm-hmm.
It ain't necessary to be circumcised.
Mm-hmm.
Not physical.
Right.
Watch this here. Is that pretty good?
Amen.
Are y'all still with me?
Amen.
Amen. We're moving right along here. I want verse 24. Amen. They was really troubling these people. You won't understand Galatians chapter 1 and verse number 6 through 9, where Paul said, I marvel that you're so soon removed from him who called you into the grace of God unto another gospel.
Yes, sir.
See, what they were doing, they had false teachers teaching another gospel.
Right.
What was the other gospel? You have to be circumcised and keep the law of Moses to be saved.
Right.
That's another gospel.
Right.
But they perverted it. Watch this here. Watch what they say. For as much as we have heard that certain which went out from us have troubled you with words, subverting your soul, saying, here's what they were saying, ye must be circumcised and keep the law of whom, watch it, go back, watch it, of whom we gave no such commandment. No such thing as a person have to be circumcised and keep the law of Moses. How do you know that? That's what the apostles said,
right,
through the teaching of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Right.
Got it? Amen. Can't bind us on us. Got it? Foot washing. I'm not going to go into all these scriptures. Watch it. They go to the Bible and see foot washing. But that ain't for us today.
No, sir.
Not foot washing. That all right? Mechanical instruments of music. No, you can't do that today. Ephesians 5:19, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in the heart to the Lord. Is that all right?
Amen,
somebody.
Amen.
I want you to go, if you would, to Ephesians 5:19. Let's go there and put it, let me show you something real quick there. Ephesians 5:19, all right? Ephesians 5:19, watch this here. Look at it here. Look at it here. Speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. Watch this, man. Watch it. Watch what the Holy Spirit says. The Holy Spirit didn't say vocal. He didn't say vocal. Why are you saying this, Brother Shannon? Because whistling is vocal.
Right.
Humming is vocal. The Holy Spirit says specifically, sing.
Amen.
A lot of my brethren want to hum. Mm-hmm. You can't hum in congregational singing.
Amen.
You've got to sing.
Amen.
Amen. You got to sing. No, no whistling, no humming.
Right.
The Holy Spirit was specific when he said sing.
Amen.
A lot of brothers say, a lot of brethren, watch this here. Look what it says. It didn't say vocal music. That's not what it said. We know singing is vocal music, but whistling is vocal. He didn't say whistling. He said sing.
Right.
Amen. Sing and make melody. Watch the instrument. I may be the only one in Memphis teaches that you have to worship God with an instrument. But the instrument is not mechanical.
Right.
It's the instrument of the heart.
Yes, sir.
Hey, man, somebody. You can't worship God without an instrument.
Right.
You can't. How you going to do that? You got to have an instrument. What's the instrument? It's the heart.
Yes, sir.
And guess what? Everybody that worship God must use their instrument.
Right.
It's a God-given instrument, right. And it's the heart. Make melody in the heart, not the piano.
Right. Amen.
Look at Colossians 3. Amen.
Amen.
That good?
Amen.
Colossians 3. Amen. And 16. That's good. That good? Colossians 3:16. That's good stuff, isn't it?
Amen.
All right, look what it says. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, watching now, teaching and admonishing one another in psalm and hymn and spiritual song. See, singing has got to be teaching.
Right.
Well, wait a minute. You can teach false doctrine. You can sing false doctrine.
Amen.
You can, amen, somebody.
Amen.
Then you know that you can teach false doctrine, but you can sing it. That's why we as God's people need to know the songs in which we sing.
Right.
What message are we sending out?
Right.
Preach, Brother Shannon.
Yes,
because you can sing a lie.
That's right.
A lot of times it sounds good. Just because it sounds good don't mean it's right.
Right.
Amen. Amen. That's good. So much more I'd like to deal with. Well, that's enough then. Take the Old Testament for example. 1 Corinthians 10, 1 through 11. 2 Corinthians 3, 6. Watch it. The Old Testament was for our learning, but the New Testament is for our liberation. That's pretty good. We're going to go on here a little bit. Do not observe days. Brethren, we need to stop being influenced by the world.
Right.
And we need to be influenced by the word. Look here. This whole idea of Christmas, Easter, Mother's Day. You notice all of these secular holidays, guess when they put Mother's Day? On the Lord's Day. No, you can't do that.
Amen.
Kyriakos, a Greek word which means that which belongs to the Lord. The first day of the week is the Lord's Day. Watch it. We don't celebrate no Easter as a religious holiday, no Christmas, no none of that.
Right.
No. Gotta preach it.
Amen.
Some of the young people don't know that.
Right.
Some of the, they get all wrapped up in the world. Well, you know, day is Mother's Day. I don't know nothing about that. How come you didn't make Mother's Day on a Monday?
Right.
Why do you want to put it on the Lord's Day? That's heathenism.
Amen,
amen, somebody. Is that all right? Do not observe days. Watch it. Tradition of men. We don't do that. Let's go first. Watch this here. Watch it. Have no AIDS. What do you mean AIDS? Let me explain that. I ain't talking about the disease, AIDS. I'm talking about ways we get our money. Now, you members of the Church of Christ here tonight, I know I won't be preaching to you about this. Bazaars and missionary societies. We don't have that. Each congregation should do its own work. We don't need another congregation doing our work. Are you listening to me? Amen, somebody. 1 Corinthians 16:1-2. Watch it. 2 Corinthians 9. 7 through 9, we don't pay tithe.
Right.
Let me do this here. We don't teach that.
Right.
We don't teach tithing is a part of the New Testament census. That's 10%. You got it? 10%. Watch this here. Most members of the Church of Christ don't even come close to this.
Amen.
Right. I know members of the Church of Christ fight denominational people about giving a tithe to their church or their pastor. But members of the Church of Christ, listen here, 99% of the members of the Church of Christ don't come to 10% at all in their giving.
Right.
And you say that you're a member of the Church of Christ, the blood-bought church, and you don't give? You don't give. You mean to tell me you make $100 and how much you give out of $100? Well, the denomination people, they give 10, so they get $10 out of $100. What do you give?
Right.
What, a tithe? We don't tithe. No, we don't tithe. No, no, we don't pay tithe. No, 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 no. That's not. We ought to give. Well, how much do you give it? Let me tell you something. Sometimes we wonder how denominational people are able to do what they do and we can't do it. Here's the reason. See, they teach their people to give at least 10%. And you know, they try to meet that. All of them don't. And guess what? With that 10%, you'd be surprised what they can do. If members of the Church of Christ would say, we don't tithe, but we give 10%, guess what? We'd have a lot of stuff too. And God will bless us. But since we wrong, guess what? We have to struggle. Sometimes people ask, Brother Shannon, how are we doing all this around here? Now, that's not the question. You need to say, Brother Shannon, how are we doing all this around here with the 1% that I'm giving?
Yes, sir.
A lot of members of the Church of Christ, they go from congregation to congregation. Some of them leave here, go to another congregation, and guess what they do? When they go over there, they don't give them nothing. They don't give. Why? They want nobody watching. They don't want preacher no giving. Why? Because let me tell you something. When you catch people who won't give properly, they have the wrong outlook on life.
Right.
Selfishness. Are you listening? Amen. Oh boy, it got quiet here. That pretty good? Amen, amen. Look here. So you need to check yourself. How's your giving? But brethren, please listen to me. God, since we know all of this, we're chosen, we're consecrated, claimed, communicating, called, watch it, Christian, and covered, and then we come up and give, watch it, just like, and you know what? Some people won't give at all. And you talking about you got all of this, and you're Christian and all this, and I don't, listen, I've got to say this. Not all black churches, not all of them, but most small black churches suffer. They won't give properly. The late Nicomas Hilldale said something to me once when I was a young preacher. I hadn't forgot it to this day. He said, Brother Shannon, if members of Churches of Christ who call us and asked us for help and support in what they're doing, if their own members would give, they wouldn't have to ask for anything. I refuse for this church. I started out on North 7 going to a different congregation soliciting help for what we're trying to do. Brother Chambers, William Chambers is not here, and Brother Brown is going on. And we left out a meeting from East Haven, East Fraser Church of Christ. We felt like we were about this low in there begging folks for their money, and their own folk wasn't giving. And I come out of it, I said, I'll never do that again in my life. No, we're not going outside of this church for no television program, nothing we're doing. We're not asking another congregation to do nothing. Why? All of us are churches of Christ. Watch this here. You mean to tell me God can't bless us? The problem is God is blessing us with the money, but we got members who are cheap and holding back.
Amen.
And God is not pleased with that.
Amen.
And get mad at me when I preach the truth.
Amen.
I'm like, you can get mad all you want. Somebody got to say it.
Amen.
We can't go out and have the women selling barbecue plates and fish on the corner to raise money for the church. I'm going to say something else. Maybe I shouldn't say it. I don't care nothing about no anniversary. I want you to, y'all give me an anniversary this year. No, I don't want that. I don't want that. No. And some of you may be offended, but I'm saying it openly. Why? Brethren, we got to get the gospel out. The way you give me an anniversary of money is put the money in the contribution so we can spread the gospel. I'm for more spreading the gospel than for myself. Right. Amen, somebody. Right. Amen. Everybody ought to have that attitude.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Wait a minute. Brethren, it's not about building in and building up a big building and all this. Listen, we got a big enough building.
Right.
We need to spread the gospel more and more and more to the Lord. I got a call, Brother Joe, on my phone from a very good friend of mine. White fella. Some of y'all know him. He's been very liberal to a lot of members here. He said, boy, you know what? We were looking and I saw you on television. So what? He said, I know that's you. I told all my friends, that's my friend. Well, what are you saying? They heard the gospel.
Amen.
Wait a minute. They heard the gospel.
All right.
I've been trying to get to him to teach him the gospel. He done sat there and looked at television. You see that? Are you listening? That's what we ought to be concerned about. Amen. Oh yeah, we know how to worship. Amen. Take up the Lord's Supper every first day of the week. We don't have no problem with that. Here's where we have problem. We have problem with our giving, watch it, and our working. Don't call the preacher Reverend, Pastor, Doctor? No. Psalm 111, verse 9. Matthew 23, 29. Roger. Do not call Sunday the Christian Sabbath.
Right.
Sunday ain't no Christian Sabbath. Sabbath means the seventh day. We worship the Lord on the first day.
Right.
That right? Pretty good. Teach the gospel of Christ, God's only plan to save mankind. Faith, repentance, confession, baptism into Christ. Amen, somebody.
Right.
Watch this here. The three works of the church. Edification, evangelism, and benevolence. Now, where are you working?
Good, mm-hmm.
This is the stopper right here.
Yes,
I've seen people in churches of Christ tear up a church and ask them where they're working. They ain't working nowhere. Wait a minute. You get two mules pulling a wagon up a hill. Guess what? They can't pull kicking each other. All that is need to go pulling that wagon.
Right.
Members of the Church of Christ need to stop feuding, fussing, and fighting and get busy. Why? We got a whole world out there.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And brethren, we're on the same team. Same team.
Yes,
amen. So when we split, all we're doing is weakening each other. Amen, somebody. That pretty good? Watch it here. Watch it, amen. We name the name of Christ. Has not denied my name, Revelation 3:8, right? No other name, Acts 4:11 and 12. Name of Christ, 2 Timothy 2:19. Nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure, having his seal. The Lord knoweth them that are his. Watch it. Let everyone that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. What does that mean? If you call yourself a Christian, how you gonna live an ungodly life? You can't do that. You can't call yourself a Christian and doing all this sinful stuff. Stop trying to follow the world. Young people, stop trying to be like the world. You mess around, you want to go out there, God will let you go and let you get lost out there. That's what happened to the northern tribe. They wanted to be like the world and God let them go all 10 tribes. You got it? Amen. They went into Assyrian captivity.
Amen.
Then, over 100 years later, Judah, the southern kingdom, guess what they did? They did the same thing, and God sent them to Babylonian captivity.
Right.
You want to be like the world? God will let you go.
Right.
He'll let you go. And a lot of members of the Church of Christ, young people, old ones, they want to be just like the world. brethren, we are, watch it, peculiar.
Yes, sir. Amen.
That's enough. Faith, repentance, confession, baptism into Christ for the remission of sin. The Lord will add you to the church. You'll be saved, born again, have God with a John, have with Jesus Christ. Now, God expects something out of you when you get in Christ. He expects you to live right. He expects you to walk right, worship right, and work right.
Amen.
That's enough.
Amen.
That's enough. Time to go. Are you here tonight? All things are ready. The one here tonight hadn't obeyed the gospel. Why don't you obey the gospel? Jesus Christ died for our sins according to the scripture. He was buried. He rose again the third day. He bought one church. Got it? To enter that one church, you got to hear and believe the gospel. I repent of your sins, confess Christ, be baptized into Christ for the remission of sin. I hope that you've enjoyed the lesson. We certainly hope that you've enjoyed this lesson. Thank you, as always, and God bless you.
Yes, Lord.